Hello there, folks. My name is Brady Glaze, and I will be your tour guide today. I will be showing you around the transportation building, and we will learn many things along the way. The first stop we will make here outside while we talk about the beautiful Golden Arches. After we talk about the arches, I will be taking you inside to see the exhibits we have lined up for you. The first of many stops is at the Rocket Locomotive. After the locomotive, I'll be taking you guys on top of the huge building to show you the Chicago Junction Station. Alright, that's enough rambling. Let's get to it. We will be beginning our tour here outside where we are looking at the great golden arches that are a beautiful attraction for anybody in the town for the fair. The architecture and elegance required to make such a breathtaking building takes quite a bit of time and resources. The building was designed by Louis Sullivan and Dankmar Adler. Altogether, the building cost $370,000, which in 1893 would be equivalent to $10 million today. The majority of the building is made of steel with some wood here and there. The arches we see here are made of wood and painted over with beautiful colors. The building was huge for its time period. The interior is full of exciting exhibits covering the history and future of the world's transportation. Let's go inside and take a look. Come on!
Well, howdy. My name's Donovan, and I'm going to show you wonderful people exactly what kind of trains we have and why they are so important. Now, if you would just follow me this way, I can lend you some knowledge on the good old Rocket. You know, 1829 wasn't only a great year because of the opening of the Liverpool and Manchester line, but because of the astonishing advancements we made with the most modern and high-speed locomotive. This engine here was made by Robert and his father George Stephenson, and gained the prize for speed, lightness, and power. You can tell that this is the real thing because of the tall chimney right at the front, cylindric boiler in the middle, and the separated firebox that you will find at the back of the train. This piece of art actually got its name from a news article where people said that they would rather ride a rocket to the moon than ride in such an extravagant vehicle as a train. Another interesting fact about this wonderful machine is on the opening day for the ceremony of the opening of Liverpool and the Manchester line, it attracted the attention of guests like British Prime Minister and the Duke of Wellington because a member of Parliament was actually hit and killed by the rocket.
Well, folks, that was really informing. Let's go check out the Chicago Junction Station.
Well, good day, tourist. I'm Tom Hartner. I work here at the Chicago Junction Station, part of the Intramural Railway. Now, the station itself is built atop the annex of the transportation building. The annex is 382,500 square feet. The Intramural Railway is around 6 miles long and has 10 stations, including the one you're looking at now. The train riding the railway is electric-powered, and it is called the L-Train. 10 to 15 trains are operating on the railway at any given moment, and they're powered by a huge electric generator. In fact, the generator is the largest piece of machinery displayed here at the World's Fair. It costs $100,000 to build, weighs 192 tons, and disperses 3,000 horsepower to all the trains in service at the time. But that's over by the forestry building. Anyways, if you want to take a ride, it will cost you 10 cents. But it's worth it. It'll get you there quick. It travels at around 30 miles per hour and makes a round trip in about 35 minutes.
Well, that's the end of the tour, folks. I hope you had a great tour and have a great time and enjoy the rest of the fair. Thanks.